Hi guys, today we will start a new chapter, Admission of a Partner. In case of admission of a partner, few necessary adjustments are required to be made, like calculation of new profit sharing ratio, sacrificing ratio, calculation of goodwill, treatment of goodwill, etc. Similarly, few accounts are to be prepared, that is revaluation account, partner's capital account, balance sheet, and in some cases cash account also, which we will learn today. So first we start with revaluation account. Why we prepare revaluation account? To know the revalued figure of asset and liability after admission of a new partner. So we will show only asset and liability in revaluation account. Look at the format. Whenever the asset increase, we show it in the credit side, or whenever it is decrease, we show it in the debit side. Similarly, whenever a liability increase, we show it in the debit side, and whenever it is decrease, we show it in the credit side. To know the profit on revaluation or loss on revaluation, which we will divide among old partner, and we transfer this profit to partner's capital account. So we write to partner's capital account or by partner's capital account at the end. Now look at partner's capital. In partner's capital, we have two sides. One is debit, another is credit with the name of the partners. So we transfer capital balance first by writing by balance brought down of old partners. Then by cash account, which is cash bought by the new partner. After that, by revaluation account, if there is a profit on revaluation, or to revaluation account, if there is any loss on revaluation. After that, we adjust goodwill account based on the given sum. This will be more clear after solving a sum. So look at the problem. From following is the balance sheet of Vikram and Betal as on 31st December 2019. In liability side, Vikram's capital is 2 lakh and Betal capital is 1,40,000. And creditor is valued at rupees 1,04,000. Asset side, building is valued at 1,40,000. Plant is 1 lakh. Furniture is 40,000. Debtor is 80,000. Stock is 62,000. And cash balance is 22,000. Total of balance sheet is 4,44,000. Next, they admitted Vishnu on 31st March 2020 for 1/5 share. That means balance sheet is given as on 31st December 2019 and Vishnu is admitted in partnership firm on 31st March 2020. So we need to prepare these accounts for these 3 months. Look at the adjustment. Building is to be appreciated by 10,000. Stock is to be valued at 67,000. Provision for bad debt is to be created on debtors at a rate 2.5%. Plant is to be depreciated by rupees 3,000. So here the first 4 adjustment is related to asset and liabilities. So we put it in the revaluation account only. After that, Vishnu brings rupees 1 lakh as capital but failed to bring rupees 20,000 as premium of goodwill. Fifth adjustment is related to partners, so we put it in the partner's capital account. Let's start solving the sum. At the top, write in the books of the firm, revaluation account. It has 2 sides, one is debit, another is credit. Look at adjustment number 1, building is to be appreciated by rupees 10,000. Appreciation means increase in the value of asset. So whenever an asset increase, we show it in the credit side of revaluation account, right? By building account 10,000. Adjustment number 2, stock is to be valued at rupees 67,000. But in balance sheet, it was given as 62,000. That means the value of stock is increased by rupees 5,000. So we again write it in the credit side of revaluation account, by stock account 5,000. Look at adjustment number 3. Provision for bad debt is to be created on debtors at a rate 2.5%. Provision always decrease the value of debtors. So Here, debtor is 80,000 and 2.5% of 80,000 is rupees. We write it in the debit side of revaluation account to provision for bad debt. That is 2,000. Adjustment number 4. Plant is to be depreciated by rupees 3,000. Depreciated by rupees 3,000 means the value of plant is decreased by rupees 3,000. So we again write it in the debit side of revaluation account. There is no more adjustment of asset and liability. So we find out the closing balance. Here credit side is more than debit side. So profit on revaluation we will consider. 10,000 plus 5,000, that is 15,000. When we subtract 2,000 and 3,000 from it, we will get 10,000. We divide this profit on revaluation equally among Vikram and Vital because no profit sharing ratio is given in the sum. So, write in the debit side to partners capital account Vikram's 5,000 as balance and Vital also 5,000 as balance. Now we will prepare partner's capital account. As I said, there are two sides with name of the partner. So particular Vikram, Vital and Vishnu. Vishnu is the new partner. Debit side. Again particulars Vikram, Vital and Vishnu in credit side. First we bought down the balance from the balance sheet. That is 2 lakh and 1 lakh 40,000 by balance BT. Next, in the credit side, cash bought by the new partner, that is 1 lakh. After that, by revaluation account, as we have profit on revaluation, so we write it in the credit side of partner's capital account. By revaluation account, in Vikram account 5,000, in Vital account also 5,000. Now, look at adjustment number 5. In adjustment number 5, Vishnu bring rupees 1 lakh as capital but failed to bring rupees 20,000 as premium of goodwill. Whenever a partner fails to bring his premium of goodwill, first we divide goodwill among old partner in given ratio and then we divide goodwill among all the partner in new profit sharing ratio. So, first we calculate new profit sharing ratio. Look at the working note. Share of Vishnu is 1 by 5 and total share we considered as 1. So, remaining share is 4 by 5. Now, capital of Vikram's share, that is 1 by 2 into 4 by 5 is equal to 4 by 10. Vital's share is 1 by 2 into 4 by 5, that is 4 by 10. Again, Vishnu's share is 1 by 5. To balance it, we multiplied it by 2 by 2 and we will get 2 by 10 as share. So, new profit sharing ratio of all three partners is 4:4:2, that is 2:2:1. Now, look at partner's capital account. First, we divide goodwill among old partner in 1:1 ratio and write it to the credit side of partner's capital account by goodwill account. 10,000, 10,000. Then we divide same goodwill in new profit sharing ratio and write it to the debit side of partner's capital account in the ratio 2:2:1. So, in Vikram's account, it is 8,000. In Vital account it is 8,000 and in Vishnu account it is 4,000. Now we will balance it to know the capital balance. Credit side is definitely more than debit side. So total of credit side in Vikram account is 2,15,000. When we subtract 8,000 from it, we will get capital as 2,07,000, which we write as to balance CD. In a same way, Vital capital is 1,47,000 and Vishnu capital is 96,000. Okay. So, we are done with revaluation account and partner's capital account. Next is balance sheet. Start from asset side. Building is 1,40,000 in the balance sheet and it is appreciated by rupees 10,000 after admission of Vishnu. So, final balance is 1,50,000. Similarly, plant is 1 lakh and it is decreased by rupees 3000. So, its current balance is 97,000. There is no change in furniture, so it will remain same as 40,000. Debtor is decreased due to provision by rupees 2000 and its previous balance was 80,000. So, now it is 78,000. Similarly, stock is increased by rupees 5,000, so its final balance is 67,000. In cash account, 22,000 is the exact balance of cash and 1 lakh is bought by the new partner. So, closing balance is 1,22,000. Now, look at the liability side. Capital of Vikram, Vital and Vishnu is taken from partner's capital account as 2,07,000, 1,47,000 and 96,000, and creditor will remain same as 1,04,000. The total of balance sheet is 5,54,000. So this is the final balance sheet after admission of a new partner, and we will always solve a sum of admission by preparing revaluation account, partner's capital account and balance sheet after admission of a new partner.
If you like this video, please click subscribe to watch more such videos. Thanks for watching.